Objects in motion.
Think of a time when you played catch with a friend. The ball left your hands, traveled through the air. And then was caught by your friend. The ball landed in a different place from where it started because it moved.
We learned from the previous lesson that an object is in motion if it is moving from one place to another. When you look at an object, you can describe its position compared to other things around it. Imagine that you are standing next to a tree when you are playing catch. The starting position of the ball is close to the tree. When the ball travels through the air, it is in motion. It stops moving when your friend catches it. The ball's position changes relative to the tree.
The tree is considered the fixed starting point. Motion is any change in position relative to a fixed starting point.
What causes motion to start?
For motion to start or stop, there must be a force, a push or a pull. When you threw the ball, you put it into motion using a push. Gravity, the force that pulls objects downward, caused the ball to drop into your friend's hand. The pushing force of your friend's hand against the ball stopped the ball's motion. Some motion is easy to see, and some is not. It is easy to see a person walk down the street. A leaf blowing in the wind. Or a ball traveling through the air after it is thrown. Other motion is hard to see. Like the move of the earth around the sun. The move of hot air balloon in the air. You know an object is in motion if you can measure changes in its position, even if you cannot see those changes. An object's change in position is compared to something else, usually something that is not moving.
And we call it fixed starting point.
You are excellent.
In the next video, we will start with the fourth lesson, stopping motion. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get new videos.